Good morning, I'm Morgan Shutters. This is your MyHighPlains.com news update. More than 5,000 customers were without power in Amarillo last night. That's after police say a man hit a pole with his truck on Boulevard and Grant. Police caught him a few minutes later. They say he was intoxicated and they found beer cans in the vehicle. Cell authorities say the accident caused a breaker to blow at the plant on Northeast 3rd Street. Also, there's an election in Portales today. Residents will decide if restaurants can sell liquor on Sundays. Polls are open from 7 to 7 at the Memorial Building Auditorium on East 7th Street. Well, the U.S. Postal Service is considering shutting down one post office in eastern New Mexico. But for folks living in the area, you'll have a chance to speak out. The Postal Service wants to move the mail processing operations from Clovis to Lubbock. Officials say a recent study found the move would save more than $600,000 a year. And there's a public meeting about that decision. It's Thursday night at the Clovis Civic Center. That starts at 6. The Postal Service will be taking comments and answering questions. Well, one Amarillo woman is taking on the city about the trees in her yard. She says some of her historic oaks were damaged by city workers. They allegedly chopped the roots of a large tree at Diane Chandler's house on 32nd and Washington this past Saturday. City officials say they're digging for a sewer project and they're trying to find a better way to do it, but Chandler says she's furious.
And they're trying to go in my yard between these two trees and kill these trees. And they keep telling me it won't kill them. Well, if you're taking roots out this size, I think it might have something to do with the tree. I'm not a tree expert, but, you know, I'm not going to let my mom's yard get torn up like this.
We've never had an issue with killing any trees that I'm aware of in all the years that I've been involved in this. So I think there won't be any issues there.
Officials say they are working to fix the problem. The project is for a 6-inch sewer line that runs through the neighborhood. Well, in the nation today, former Penn State assistant football coach Jerry Sandusky will face some of his accusers in court. Sandusky is charged with 50 counts of child sexual abuse with 10 boys. He's been under house arrest on new charges since last week. Sandusky says he is innocent. Also today, the United States Transportation Secretary and Mothers Against Drunk Driving will announce a DUI crackdown for the holidays. They'll also release new data on drunk driving statistics from last year. Also, we're giving away a $100 gift card on MyHighPlains.com each weekday till December 22nd. December 23rd, we give away $1,000 in gift cards. Just go to MyHighPlains.com to enter for your chance to win. Well, last night was the 10th annual Tree of Angels ceremony in downtown Amarillo. The Panhandle Victims Assistance Coalition puts that on every year. It's to honor the lives affected by abuse. More than 200 victims and their family members attended and brought an angel ornament to add to the tree. And remember, you can get more news, weather, and more here on MyHighPlains.com, where we stream the news live. You also can get more from us on Facebook and Twitter. Just search for KMR NBC4. Please like our fan page. For your MyHighPlains.com news update, I'm Morgan Shutters.